20 million.
So what are we going to spend it on?
Car.
Gotta get a car. I can't get no
sleep. Let me tell you the nice thing about this car.
It's not the speed. Actually, I'm lying. It is the speed.
Good enough for Bond, good enough for us.
BMW, bad man's wheels.
0 to 60 in
5.3.
Not bad.
It's blue.
And the lady in the front?
The spirit of ecstasy.
Handling?
Handling? Very good.
Teddy loves it.
Teddy probably gets it most evenings.
Now that's my sort of style. Smooth, sophisticated, discreet, good taste. The Aston Martin Vantage.
You mean overpriced, pretentious, and outdated.
Ha, unlike your Mini.
Once again, mine is bigger than yours.
This spoiler here is plastic. It's over £6,500.
But then this is the Aston Martin Vantage. V8 engine with twin superchargers producing 550 brake horsepower. 0 to 60 in just under 4 seconds. Top speed 200 miles an hour. Rather nice. What's it worth?
£190,000. Has got a certain attitude, hasn't it?
The Beach Jet 400, nice baby, new, 4 million, used about 2.5. I'll tell you, my grandmother's got her eye on this one. I don't want to pressurise you, but
hold on.
How many people does this take?
This is about 7 seats, so
okay.
7-8 passengers typically.
And yeah. If we wanted to take a seat out and build in a bar,
you've got bars in there.
We've
already.
We've got bars in there.
Yep, this one does have a bar.
For £2 million, they'll chuck in a loo free in case of personal turbulence.
And loads of little colourful dialy things.
I wonder if he's the right man for the job.
Golf Bravo Tango Foxtrot, over. Yep, Golf Bravo Tango Foxtrot, permission to take off, please.
Unaware France for 279.
Roger.
Now, what do I run here, Hanson?
Hey, Hanson.
That's fine, that'll clear, no problem.
Very nice. I like the retro chrome. Does it work for you?
Retro chrome?
Always cool.
Mm.
Always. It's good.
Should we go?
Yeah.
So we got the £20 million then.
Yes, we bought a very nice car.
Decked out in haute couture.
Bought a couple of very nice watches too.
We even bought a plane.
Very, very nice plane. And we've got the ladies.
Hi!
Yes. All we need now is a gin palace, really, isn't it?
Yeah, just a wee boat.
Hello!
That's nice, too. £2 million gin palaces floating off the Devon coast.
Now, I won't bore you with the fact this baby cruises at 26 knots and has a top speed of 34 knots, and under my fingers is the equivalent power of 27 saloon cars.
Wow.
And of course, her interior is not bad either, is it, darling?
Hello, saloon.
Ah, champagne, how appropriate. Of course, the saloon here is decked out in madron wood. It's from Africa, you know. Very nice, too. And of course, all the electronics either of us might need. A bit of a television there, and just next to it,
a CD player.
This is the best thing you can do with your money. It's the best money spent so far, isn't it? This is gorgeous, wonderful.
I think this is as much fun as you can have with fiberglass.
Yes, certainly is. You enjoying it, ladies?
Oh, it's lovely, Nigel.
Who's Nigel? Who's Nigel?
I don't know.
Where do you get Nigel from?
Now, a wealthy chap really needs a billiard room in life, but what the hell, we're not proud, snooker will do.
Yeah, time to think about sport and women and winning ways with both.
Nice to see you winning something today.
Yeah, well.
After all the girls we've met.
Nick, they're using you to get to me.
What sort of men do you go for?
What sort of men do I go for? Generally, I like long hair.
He's been had up for this sort of thing before. He's been had up for it, you know. They shouldn't have let him out. He tries this all the time, and it never works. And it's a bit of an embarrassment, and I'm going to go and have to rescue her right now.
So, just a matter of interest, because we're doing a thing here, we've tried to look as different as possible here and to give people the option.
Yeah.
Which of us would you prefer?
Yeah. There you go.
I have to say you.
What is going on?
You know, I kissed her.
Well, she gave me a number. Oh,
breakfast?
Yeah, breakfast. Modest selection, that was all I could find. There you go. Okay.
Can we press you to a banana or a pear or something?
It's a phone call for yourself.
For me?
Yes, for yourself.
But no one knows I'm here, I don't think. All right, I'll see you in a minute.
Yeah, see you in a minute.
That phone call, there was no one there.
Yeah, most amusing.
Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter.
Oh no, not again.
Typical.
In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. All the joy you can give to each brand new...
Right then, Nick.
Yeah, fine,
mate.
Made me happy. Hello? Daniella, how clever of you to find me. Yes, on our way to Tunisia. Very nice of you to call me. Mark. Yes, he's here. Hang on.
Asparagus and bacon in a wonderful sauce.
And tureen of pâté with foie gras.
This is acceptable to mix the foie gras with...
Absolutely, that's what's so good about it, because you've got a very sort of cheap country-style pâté, and then you've got the richness and the expensive part of the foie gras.
Wow, that's exquisite. Fantastic. Yeah, it really is. Foie gras is where it's at.
Now that we've come into some money and money is no object, what sort of things should we be trying?
Well, obviously, if money's no object, you can go for the caviar, go for truffles, all these expensive things, things like lobster.
So last thing I know, I was having cocktails in the Savoy, and I wake up to this. I mean, where are we?
At sea, mate. Remember Michelle Roux said, get out and get fresh lobster, mate, and this is where you get them.
It stinks. And another thing, there's no bar.
Now, you see, that's fishy. This is our Cornish mate, Danny. So how long we got to wait for these lobsters then? How long do you put the things down for?
About 24 hours.
24 hours? Help! 24 hours, where's the Coast Guard? Help! We'll be drinking seawater soon, or drinking our own urine or something.
Oh,
mutiny!
Oh, please!
Mutiny!
Oh.
I'm not drinking anybody's urine!
Good God!
Get me off!
Come on up.
Come on, you beauty! Hey!
There's one in it! Oh, very nice, look at this!
Look at that beauty! Beat that!
A bit on the small side.
I don't believe it. You would have to go one better, wouldn't you?
Now that's what you call a lobster sunshine.
Now this is in no way indicative of my own physical prowess. I can't believe you got the big one.
However, mine is much bigger.
Hi, yeah, is that Lobster Zara's? Perfect, right. Listen, cash is no problem. I just need the biggest lobster you've got. Give me the biggest beast you've had in all year, and I need it delivered, and I need it today. Thank you.
We'll be pleased to know, Daniella, that we've got dinner ready, and I'd like to show you mine, so to speak. And size, I think you'll agree, is important. So would you like to take a look at that? Pretty impressive, I think you'll agree.
Very impressive.
Yes?
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more about size being important.
Take a look at it.
There you go. You know, I think it is indicative of, you know, the catcher.
It's looking fabulous.
Hang on, I bought that one. Hang on. Excuse me, I bought that one. How come he's got that one?
I'm sorry,
I did buy that. I have caught. No.
And you did some serious drinking, Mark.
Okay.
I expect you had an early night?
Certainly did, and you?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, shit!
So Chelsea are through.
Yeah.
Met with the Villa going out.
Yeah, and United as well.
Yeah. Game of footy on the beach?
Yeah, footy, yeah.
I'm greatly looking forward to this because we're in the kitchen of Michael Cairns, who is a top chef.
Yep, and he's going to teach us how to make a dish that will impress anybody. That's the important thing about cooking, isn't it? Impressing people.
Impressing people.
But we come here not for the prospect of a romantic tryst, but to continue our culinary education as an investment for future conquests.
This starter's a bit fancy, isn't it?
Yes, it's almost 70s art.
A bit like an upmarket generation game,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, indeed. Important to get the seasoning cooking in, okay?
Then so you put that in straight away.
Straight away.
Right.
In we go, okay?
Wow.
One side up, okay.
Daniella?
My scallop, you saw that? My scallop.
Have my scallop, Daniella. No, seriously. My scallop.
I think you're probably full by now.
She had my scallop too.
I'm a little bit worried about our image.
It's not that we haven't got the money, because we have. We've got the status symbols.
But there's something missing.
I think it's called breeding, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Heritage.
Ancestry.
Roots!
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 Old Bob here not only tinkles on the ivories,
he flogs lordships.
Sort of titles are us.
Very good.
Listen, we have some money and we'd like to achieve some ancestry. Can you help us out at all?
How much you want to spend?
Bingo! Problem solved. Social mobility, love it. So how much?
For a lordship of a manor, you're talking about £6,000-£8,000.
Is that all?
So really quite within the reach of a lot of people.
I like to think that these titles are very democratic. All you need is the money to pay for them.
Now this woman is class. Una Mary was the social correspondent for Tatler. She was a Deb and all that.
Well, she should be able to sort us out.
We're considering buying either a lordship or a barony to help us along.
Kiss of death.
Really?
Ooh. Absolute
it
kiss
shows
of
like
death.
A badge.
You will be completely laughed at. Anybody who does that, a lot of people do. That's desperate. And it's so phony.
What, phonies? So how can we be outstanding without standing out?
It needs the Savile Row double-breasted suit, probably cashmere.
Right.
And the Turnbull and Assos shirts, and the very, very traditional shoes from Lobs.
Right.
A very sort of side-parting short
really?
A little bit. No stubble.
No.
Too designer, too smart.
Okay, so we look like brats. What about behaviour?
I think it's best to be natural and charming. And don't get drunk.
Don't get drunk?
You know, the great thing about drinking champagne in the hailstones is it keeps it cool, have you noticed?
Ooh.
Look, mate, the only way we're going to look like old money is to completely go for it. Act the part.
Get into the role.
Old money.
Very, very old money.
From a long time ago. You know, Marcus, I absolutely adore Devon.
Because I think I'm just a little bit in love with you. You do say such lovely things.
Have you noticed how the clouds are white and yet the sky is blue?
You really should lay off the laudanum a little.
Come along, my good man.
Now look, mate, I don't want to get heavy or anything, but just because we're in the part and all that, I can't honestly say that I want to shag it.
Oh my God, now it's unrequited love.
Get lost.
You know, at public school, they always call each other by their surnames, don't
they? Oh, like we're Atherton, it's Athers.
Athers and Blofeld, Blowers. I've known a few Blowers, actually.
That makes you Markers. That's like something you put down.
Well, you'd be knickers, which is something you pull down, isn't it?
So, we need to get acquainted with the gentry.
I need some advice from some socialites.
I mean, of course, it's like a guy who pulls up to the light. Do you have a Porsche, by the way?
No. Okay, okay, so we've been in one, but that's not the same as owning one.
It's like a guy who pulls up to the lights in the Porsche. Now, my immediate reaction would be to look at him and think, oh, God, I'm lost. What a...
That's fine.
What an idiot. You can use it when it's on.
You need to be social climbers, don't we?
Have you got any tips for us that we can suddenly become new money transformed to the old?
Your suit's a little sharp. I think your hair ought to be taken on a one-way taxi trip to Trumpers and visit Mr. Park.
Oh, right, that's your...
And you'll probably come out looking like a criminal, but never mind, you look fairly much like one at the moment.
What, this Ponzi stuff is all very well. We want to get out there and do something physical, don't we? You know,
always.
Prove our virility and our manliness.
What do you have in mind?
Oh, it's like a contact sport, a vicious high-speed contact sport.
Look, it's quite simple. We've got a ball each, as far as I can work out, OK? And we start back there, we go through the first hoop, and we go round the course, and if I hit your ball, I can roquet it, OK? And I stand on my ball, I bash yours away to the other side of the garden, and then I get another go, and that's basically it.
You just hit it with a hammer.
Listen, Nick, if you're going to be a lord, you've got to learn how to play croquet, for heaven's sake! Sometimes he's just got no breeding.
Breeding? Don't tell me about breeding, mate. I do it all the time. No, seriously, sport is a metaphor for life, Mark. Play the game fairly, decently, and you probably won't win anything.
Spot a bother?
Inhaled it, old man. You ought to try. It's very good. Rain?
What rain?
I have no idea what he's talking about. Yeah. Anyway, end of part one. Actually, is that in part one already? We've got half a bottle left.
Well, we can drink that during the break.
Good idea. Are we going to let them end the part like that?
They're a couple of bounders.
So, this lordly thing is going rather well, don't you think?
Yeah, it is. We've got some people coming down, though.
Have we? We're entertaining tonight.
We are.
Well, we better check the old cellar book, then.
Yeah, how are we doing on the Alsace?
No Alsace.
Brandy?
No, run out.
Burgundy?
Last week.
Chablis and white Burgundy?
Finished yesterday.
Claret?
No, we're out of claret.
Champagne?
We're out of bubbles. You know, I think we're out of booze.
We're out of booze?
Out of booze.
It's a disaster.
A crisis.
We better get on to our supplier.
Get on to him straight away.
By the way, who are they?
I don't know one of them.
Running out of booze?
It's the end of the world as we know it.
It means when we wake up, it's the best we're going to feel all day.
Lucky we're here, then.
Berry Brothers, offer you to royalty. Possibly the best vintner in the galaxy.
Certainly the oldest.
Looks sort of crusty from the outside.
But there's nothing crusty about their chaps or their wine.
Or their Montrachet at £143 a bottle.
I can't come up with a word for that. You can describe it with the aroma?
I wouldn't want to, actually. Because I'm getting a...
Is that the baby's nappy?
I'm getting a baby's nappy.
The famous baby's nappy.
I know we're not here to get trousered, but you have to admit it. Drinking just brings a great big grin to your face.
Yeah, next Chateau Yquem.
A bottle of 1784 Yquem was sold a couple of years ago at Christie's, and I forget how much it was, but I think it was something like £35,000.
Really?
Is that ever going to get drunk, that bottle of £35,000?
Would you drink a £35,000 bottle of wine?
Just before I die. Either just before I die, or, yes, after I'd actually had about eight other bottles, and I go, why don't it just... I've got one. Where is it?
Welcome back. And slip into our sack.
No.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. No.
So, what are you doing? Nervous Nins. Mark, stop gardening and tell me what's going on the show this week.
Well, Danielle is coming on this episode.
Make up your own jokes at home because he's really selling that gag there. But I think sport is the thing. Posh sport, like shooting.
Fishing.
For compliments, maybe. Or sailing.
bollocks!
I nicked it because it was what? Shooting, fishing, polo! You haven't seen a train.
I forgot. If you're going to steal my lines, I just have, I've got a script.
I've been thinking again. We've done materialism and class.
Absolutely.
But how do men of great wealth and education, like us, pass their idle moments?
Chat out women?
Close, Mark. Sport. That's what we should do. The sporting life.
Football. Let's go to the World Cup.
It's far too vulgar. Polo. Yes. Let's go and see the Grey Sisters team. That's Victoria. She's very nice. So you see, this is how it works. I have sugar in the car. I think I can hack this. I'm really quite good. How about you, Mark?
Okay. I don't think Principal wants to go.
Does it actually look like I'm just bouncing up and down without any sort of control? Yeah, I thought so.
Basically, I was number one in the thick of it, and you were out there grazing in the corner.
Whoops.
I scored three times. Three times, did you?
Oh, damn. Well, I thought I rode much better, cantered around. I did miss some of the action, granted.
There you go. Come on.
He's better than you.
I think you'd make a good stable boy.
I'm better than you.
I had a thing about newsreaders. Female.
Yeah.
No, really.
No.
No, I did. Jan Leaving.
Oh, absolutely.
Sue Lawley.
Who's the one with the legs? Big long legs.
I thought they all had them.
The call of the wild, Nick. Man against nature, having to hunt for your very survival.
What are you on? This is clay pigeon shooting.
You are so unromantic. This is the Ladies' Wood Shooting School. We're here with our mate Lady Apsley and her mate Michael and some very pricey shotguns.
What are we looking at for a pair of purdes?
Oh, you'd be looking at about £50,000 for a new pair today.
Mm. Oh, well, I think we can run to that.
And if you go up there now, you might be able to get them ready for the season.
So here we are, gentlemen, all ready to go. I just have one question to ask. Mark?
Mm-hmm?
What are you wearing?
Lady Sarah's very good, isn't she?
I don't think I'd want to argue with Lady Sarah, would you? Perfect shot. I'm quite looking forward to this. A bit apprehensive. It's all a bit loud. Okay.
Pull! Move a hand. Oh, well done. Good shot. You missed it.
Not bad. Very good indeed.
You missed that?
I know, but it was really close.
Forward with the safety.
Pull. Now, right ahead. Now, it's about the same slice. Pull. Now, move ahead. Yes! Pull. Now, move ahead. Yes, good shot. And then we're going to try a double, because Nick's doing rather well.
I see, Michael. Favouritism.
Of course, Mark's saving him quite a bit of money, because they can collect up all the colours he's missed and use them again.
Pull. Move ahead. Yes!
Bravo! Oh, look, red ones. Sarah's at it again.
Perfect. Next.
This is it, the pressure shot. Pull.
You missed.
Pull.
My go. One, two, three.
What a boy.
Yes.
The smugness of it all.
I've got a very special cartridge here this time for Mark. And these cartridges, in fact, have never been known to miss.
What are you saying?
Well, you should do a lot better with this one.
Pull! Whoa! Pull!
Oh, yeah! What a start!
How about that, Nick? You've got some competition.
So what are we going to do on the show, then?
Well, Daniella's coming on this episode.
Make up your own jokes at home. She is, of course, a very sporty girl. She was a dressage champion for the Isle of Wight, you know. No, she wasn't. She was the dressage champion for the Isle of Man.
Well,
so I'll go over here. I'll just start again, if that's all right.
Okay, you do that. Start again over there.
She's, of course, a very sporty girl.
She's the Isle of course.
Yes, I know. I was going to try and carry that through, but thanks for mentioning that. That's all right. I was going to just try and hope that nobody noticed, but that's it. No, I'll just fly off into the distance. Thank you.
are bored. For God's sake, are bored. I mean, we've got the car in the driveway, we've got the helicopter parked outside the estate, the plane on the runway, the boat down in the harbour. We've drunk a sackload of wine. And what's left? I want to be immortal.
You need to go to France, existentialism, World Cup, talk to Paco Rabanne, meet some French fillies, and find out what makes them tick.
What's this?
What do you mean, what's this? This is our transport.
It's not even new.
This is heritage. This is class. This is French.
Ça.
Voilà.
Allons-y.
Le ferry.
Le voyage.
Au Renoir.
Bonnes vacances.
Non, ce n'était pas le radeau de la Méduse, ce bateau, qu'on se le dit.
The captain and I struck up a great rapport. We had so much in common. We were great mates.
I've got a boat.
J'ai un bateau.
220.
220?
Vous avez un bateau?
220.
Lots of buttons to explore with the captain.
Maybe not.
This one looks fun. Red, always a good sign, usually a bit of excitement. And one of those round and round things. Right, I think that's a abandoned ship.
I'd like to make a film.
You'd like to make a... Well, I'd like to make a film.
Mark, come out and join us.
Everywhere I go, people laugh at me.
We won't laugh, Mark. I promise you, Mark, we won't laugh. Come out now, please.
Promise.
Promise. Just get out for the seat, please. Action. Cut! Cut!
Cut!
No,
we're just getting to the passion.
Daniella, no, you're fabulous, darling. Fabulous. Just walk with me here a second, Mark. Why were you mumbling?
Well, that's how they speak in French films. I mean, you can just use the subtitles then, yeah?
Action!
Je t'aime, t'aime. Fancy a snog.
Cut! Go in for the kiss. That's fabulous. Go in. Nice look, Daniela. Beautiful. Fabulous. Thank you very much.
How can I go in for the kiss? You're in the middle of us.
Cut! 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 Cut!
Sur la plage abandonnée, coquillages et crustacés.
One effect of all this garlic, soleil, waves and booze is it tends to turn Mark into an incredibly deep and profound analyst of French culture.
I think they like a degree of I think there's a degree to which they, I think I'm never going to finish this sentence. Bagsy, Brazil.
Just we knew.
These English players, they don't know what they do.
Mine is especially bad. He cannot play for Toffee.
La France. They expect to win the World Cup, pas.
Yeah, but this is very strange because you are talking to me and you are made of metal.
And your legs are glued together.
So what, fish face? Look at your complexion. If I could get off this bar, I'd come over and smack you one.
C'est pas un hasard s'il est tard. Pas un hasard, j'y suis en train de voir.
Paris, so romantic. I say, steady on. What can you say about this place? Chic, fast, rude, indescribably beautiful, sexy, cultured, beer £37.50 a glass. Only joking. Mais c'est plus cher, mais aussi une cité de l'amour.
And I'm poetic, and I'm a warrior, and I'm a swordsman, I'm all those things.
Absolutely.
I'm a hero.
Mm-hmm.
And you did the makeup, yeah, and it looks all right?
It looks fabulous.
Yeah?
Mm.
She's gonna love me.
An intellectual warrior and a true warrior. He's coming home from the front and you love him. Off you go, Ma.
Mon âme brûle, ma chérie.
What? Why's she laughing?
This looks better. This looks better, yeah?
Much better. The other one's very bulbous, very unattractive.
Right.
Cut.
What is it?
So this is the great moment of passion.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
This is the climax.
This is where you go in there.
She wants him.
She wants him terribly.
It's the kiss.
It's the kiss.
Right.
Do your best.
Wrong.
Ça, c'est l'histoire de
Melody Nelson.
Qu'à part moi-même, personne n'a jamais pris dans ses bras. Ça vous étonne, mais c'est comme ça.
So, what's all this then?
Just a humble little end of series, Prezi.
Looks bloody dangerous to me.
Safe as houses, my friend.
Coming in?
I'm not sure, actually. I'm not absolutely sure. Well, it's very broad of you to buy me a present, old bean, I have to say.
Well, you've supplied the bubbly and...
Well, very least I can do under the circumstances.
Just to a lovely, graceful trip. So what is your problem with football anyway, old boy? You really don't like it. What? Come on, what's the matter?
Well, it's not true, actually. I'm quite a keen supporter of football.
So who do you follow then? Come
Spurs.
On. Spurs? Oh, mate, you should have told me. Across the bear.
Oh, it's getting a bit... I think we're landing. Oh, hang on, we're on the drift. This is good.
Pour ne pas mettre pied à terre
devant Paulette.
Faut dire qu'elle y mettait du cœur, c'était la fille du facteur.
What a fantastic present.
You ready?
Et depuis qu'elle avait 8 ans, elle avait fait dans le
sud. Not funny, you tried to kill me.
I didn't, I did it out of the goodness of my heart. I thought it was gonna be graceful, I thought you'd love it.
You tried to kill me.
I didn't try and kill you. I just wanted you to have a little bump, that's all.
So we're sat here in the rain, 5 weeks on, having spent £20 million, and now it's all gone.
It's all over. Who'd have thought it, eh? Still, got some bubbly.
We had a lot of fun though. The cars were fantastic.
They were fantastic, yeah.
And the travel, going out to Tresco, the Scilly Isles, that was lovely as well.
Tresco was marvellous, wasn't it? Champagne tasting, we did that.
Oh, you remember that, do
you? Moments.
Foggy memories. Oh, it's all gone, so what?
So what? We've
Money's
got Daniella.
Not everything, is it? We've got Daniella.
Yeah, right.
Money obviously does mean something.
Still never mind, we've got a bottle of bubbly. It's just you and me against the world, just how we started out.
On your own, mate. Mine, I think.
lean on me when you're not strong.
Come on, mate, let's load the fiver. Let's go and get a beer, eh?
Yeah?
Yeah,
come on. Oh, top one.
I'll help you carry on, for it won't be...
Oh, hang on.
Hello? Daniella? Oh, yes. I'm by the ocean. And I have loved the ocean, and my joy of youthful sports was on thy breast to be. Or perhaps even she walks in beauty like the night of cloudless climes and... What? Mark, yeah. Hang on.